If you're using Perplexity day-to-day like me, you know it's already pretty good at doing research. But Google just launched an AI research assistant, Deep Research, that really caught my attention. It claims to have agentic capability to help you create multi-step research plan that you can review and modify. And I know most of you might be thinking, should I switch? So in this video, let's find out how they compare. And at the end of this video, I'll also share some of my thoughts about both tools. Let's go. For Google Deep Research, it's now exclusively available through the Gemini Advanced subscription plan. So it's like an add-on features to the existing Gemini app. While Google is also planning to integrate more Gemini features, including Deep Research for existing Google Workspace user. As for Perplexity, the Pro plan is a standalone plan. Just like Gemini, you can always upgrade from the free plan if you want. Both of them charge a similar pricing of around $20 per month. But for the AI models, for Deep Research, you can only access to the Gemini model. And I expect it will upgrade to the latest 2.0 model once it's become stabilized. While on Perplexity, you can always switch to different advanced AI models, including the latest trending models, DeepSeek or O1 model. So it can be a strong plus if you like the flexibility to switch between models. But note that both have usage limit. For Perplexity Pro, you have around 300 per searches for now. And for Deep Research, it's not clearly specified. Google just mentioned you will get notified if you're close to the research limit. One more thing to note is, on Deep Research, currently it doesn't support any file upload. Unlike Perplexity, which you can build your own knowledge base by feeding your own data that might be relevant to the research. All right, the first thing we want to evaluate is the research efficiency. Because when we do research, speed and flexibility is a huge factor. So how fast it can give answers without endless back and forth, and how flexible it is to refine our research direction. Let's just try using a very simple research topic around responsible AI. So I would just ask both to give me the key trends in responsible AI. To use Deep Research, make sure you select the Gemini with Deep Research mode. Then you can type your research questions. It will first generate a research plan for you. I would say they are detailed, well thought and comprehensive research plan with valid question. Some of them are not even included in my first prompt. So if you don't like it, you can edit the plan. Though I would say the experience can be better and more intuitive, as I expect when I click edit research plan, I can just directly edit it instead of making another prompt. Let's try to use search operators to pull only PDF files. And obviously, you can see the research can't understand that, and we will need to explicitly state that in the prompt. While on Perplexity, there's no research plan. It will pull the resource right away based on what you mentioned in the prompt. No more, no less. But you can just edit the query and use search operators if you want to adjust, and then it will immediately update the response for you. While on Deep Research, after you click Start Research, the process is much slower. It usually takes around 8 to 10 minutes to fully load the response depending on your research topics. And in this case, it searched for 24 sources. And the good thing is you can export it directly to Google Doc, and it is ready to make more detailed changes. The document is also well formatted with detailed citations on the sources, which you can import it to other Google products like NotebookLM if you want. And on Perplexity, the response time is much faster with 11 sources, which is not too bad. And if you don't like a particular source, you can uncheck it, which is the flexibility you don't have on Deep Research. And also, I like how Perplexity always number the source in each key point compared with Deep Research, so it's easier to trace if you get many sources. And there are also different follow-up questions available to inspire your research direction. And this is not provided by Deep Research, so you need to ask it to give you follow-up question ideas. But I would say in this case, most of them are just for generic AI and not specifically for responsible AI. And both of them allow you to share the report to anyone with a link. So overall, I would say both of them have good research efficiency, depend on the use case, whether you value interactive searching or formal research documentation. But I would say Perplexity might be slightly better than Deep Research in terms of efficiency and offer more flexibility to adjust the search directions and refine the scope. Another important areas for research are source reliability, information depth, and output quality. Because oftentimes we want to make sure the source are reliable, that we can trust, up to date, and we also want output is actually useful that we can use in our projects. So let's say this time our research topic is AI agent, which is definitely an on-trend topic right now. And here is the research plan generated by Deep Research. We'll ask it to research the current state of AI agents, focus on key players, capabilities, implementation approaches, and real-world applications, and I will use the same plan to prompt on Perplexity. Now, on deep research, a total of 64 websites are used. So you can scroll down to the bottom for the full list, and looking at the list, they are quality and from reputable brands, at least for most of them I have heard about, like Salesforce, IBM, Zapier, Medium. But same time, it seems most of them are mainly service provider instead of other media or other source type. And discussion threads, YouTube videos are not being used. But I know there are lots of discussion happening around AI agents on YouTube and Reddit, or even academic source like Archive. And clicking on the source, you can see it will highlight the exact part it used to generate the response, just like on NotebookLM, which I really like. And most of them are up to date, some even are recently published, so source reliability is good. And also every key point has the source as a citation, even though it is the same source, which can be a good thing if you prefer that. But for me, I found it is a bit unnecessary. As on Perplexity, a total of 57 sources are used, and I like how it always details the reasoning steps so you know its thought process. And when you expand the source list, you can see it covers different source variety, not just only the big brand Oracle, but also other tech media like Tech Informed, TechCrunch, Yahoo Finance, and also other social media like YouTube videos talking about AI agents, LinkedIn posts, and even IBM community forums, which definitely helps in expanding the diversity of response. They're also very timely, so I would say source reliability is also good. As for information depth, deep research response is obviously more comprehensive, covering each question in a plan and well-structured with good flow, with different section headings. It also uses specific examples with data, like in the real-world application sections, how customer service agents increase results by 40%. And on Perplexity, is also following similar structure and flow, starting with the definition, key players, capability, implementation, but the response you can see is more condensed and more high level. So I would say deep research has better information depth in this case. As for the output quality, let's take a closer look. So on deep research, I note for a few sections, it just used one source to generate the whole output. Like these AI agents limitation section, every point is based on one single source only. And when you click on the source is actually not talking about AI agents, but more generally on AI. And it is just pulling the keywords here. So I would be doubtful if I should trust it, especially for such comprehensiveness. But on Perplexity, you can see the response is more useful. And for Perplexity response, most of the section use at least 2 to 3 sources to ensure it's less biased. And also the output I found is more meaningful to me, like the capability of AI agents, although it just has 5 bullet points. They're much more specific to me, like automation, decision making, collaboration, instead of pulling every buzzwords like on deep research. And same case for implementation approach. You can see it is more useful, like incremental integration using multi-agent system, instead of on deep research, just floating some random keywords here like defining objectives, data preparations, platform selection, which I feel is more like a step-by-step rather than approaches. So in terms of output quality, I found for this particular research topic, Perplexity does a better job. But to be fair, I must say from my experience, Google Deep Research can also provide useful output and thorough analysis, but it really depends on your research topic and the sources it gathers in the first place. Now, let's also evaluate the ability to retain context and cross-referencing. Because when we do research, it's important to remember what we have discussed and build meaningful connections on it from multiple sources. We'll use the same AI research topic. Our first follow-up question is to answer it to based on the mentioned use case and provide how we can measure AI agent performance and to connect these metrics to the business outcome discussed. So on deep research, I noticed the time to response is slow, even for a follow-up prompt like this, at least a few seconds to fully load it. And also on on the follow-up prompt, just 3 to 5 sources are used, unlike in the initial research plan with much more sources. So it's just similar to the normal search experience in the Gemini Advanced. For the response, deep research is doing a good job in retaining context. The metrics are referring back to the specific use case it mentioned in the original report, and they are also specific, like first call resolution, effort speed to answer, and mentioning how these metrics link back to the business impact, which I like it. As for Perplexity, instead of tie back to the use case, it first mentioned about the metrics, which are similar to what deep research mentioned, but it doesn't really closely tie them with all the use case as mentioned earlier. And the metrics are less specific compared with deep research, like the finance use case, task completion rate, and revenue growth metrics are somehow general to me. So I would say deep research does a better job in context retention. Let's try another question to test the cross-referencing ability. So this time I will ask them to compare the capabilities claimed with initial implementation results and early real user feedback, and to identify gaps and contradictions between market features and real-world performance. So for deep research, I like how it first summarized the overstated capabilities. It also organized information into clear sections, but I note the analysis tends to be more general without using specific examples to back up the claims. And also, like the early user feedback, the source is more than 2 years ago, so most of them are more high-level analysis. And for Perplexity, I found the response is more specific. It first identifies where the specific gap is, comparing market claims versus real-world performance one by one. So taking reference from case studies and then highlighting contradictions with specific examples. Although it still lack of the real user feedback I would have expected, the cross-referencing ability, I would say, is better on Perplexity in this use case. It used more sources than deep research for every follow-up prompts, 19 sources in total. So make sure it has multiple views and cross-validates claims across different sources better. All right, rating time. Both of them can provide reliable sources and answer your research questions. Of course, you always need to fact-check yourself no matter which one you use. For deep research, the initial research plan is always detailed and comprehensive, and the ability to maintain context through the chat is better. But for now, I see it lacks flexibility to refine the search plan in directions unless you spend time tweaking the prompt inputs, giving it really specific directions. And every follow-up prompt is using the standard Gemini search experience with few sources unless you initiate a new research. Also, even though it can search a lot of sources, sometimes even over 100 websites, but does it mean the quality is always better? And in fact, I didn't find the output qualities is significantly improved consistently. And even for some cases, it may be too biased that it just used only big brand websites that may lack source diversity. Also, I found it may not be so efficient if you just want to do some quick analysis, quick research at a high level, as every search takes more time compared to Perplexity. So does it really save you lots of time? Initially, on the planning stage, maybe, but speaking from the whole project from start to finish, I doubt that would be the case. As for Perplexity, it's more efficient, as the response time is always faster. It's also easier to tweak the search plan and narrow down the scope with its different focus mode. And what I like is the diversity of the sources and ability to cross-referencing. So even though it may not go as many sources as deep research initially, I found the output qualities is somehow more insightful with its search flexibility, follow-up with also detailed searches. Another big plus for me is it can switch models. You can even use the reasoning model O1, DeepSeek R1 to maximize the output quality. So unfortunately, I still find Perplexity is doing a slightly better job than Google Deep Research overall. I'm not saying Deep Research is bad. I can see it has high potentials given Google's huge website database and improving Gemini model. But for now, I just don't find it is super impressive. And I can see it may be more suitable for doing academic research requiring lots of comprehensive citations or any research that needs formal and detailed documentation and formatting. Another thing is, I know for some people, they think deep research is an AI search engine. But if I were Google, why would I position deep research as an AI search engine? As Google is already pulling lots of resources on AI overviews on its search result page. But instead, I think it might be possible if Google integrate deep research as an extra function on its regular search, just like the pro search on Perplexity. Then it may make more sense. Both tools have different purpose and positionings, although they have similar functions. sense. And of course, you can always combine them with other tools like NotebookLM into your research workflow. I'd imagine both of them work well. And if you want more inspirations, there are some powerful research techniques that you can use on both tools to get higher quality insights faster. I share them on my community. You can find the link in the description to join. And if you prefer Perplexity more for now, also watch this video about how to use it with NotebookLM to speed up your research process. I'll see you next time.